Yeah, but I want to go to a question from a viewer from Big Stone County who says, what's the future of the Appleton prison? We really need the legislature to support this for West Central Minnesota. Let's start with you, Representative Nornes.
I support it, and I know that there's going to be an effort again to bring it up and see what happens. I need to convince the governor that it's a good idea and others, but I believe if there isn't a need, then we don't have to worry about it. But if there is a need, to me, that's good for that facility, which is ready to go. It's very, very good for the community that desperately needs more jobs out in that part of Minnesota. And so it's a win-win, I think, and it's state jobs in the end. So you're winning in three different ways, and they're good-paying jobs. And I don't think we have to buy it. We can just lease it. And then if down the road we decide it's not needed anymore or isn't working anymore, then you just end the lease. So to me, that's a fourth reason why we ought to do it. So.
Well, I've had many conversations on this issue for many, many years. The governor has made it very, very clear that the only way there will be anything happening at Appleton is if the state purchases it. He is not interested in opening the prison as a private prison or even leasing it and having state employees.
And I think the only thing that's really on the table is either leasing it or buying it, right? I mean, that there's no real talk about going back into the private prison operation.
It's state operated, so it would not be private. It's just privately owned, though.
The governor has made it very clear that he's not going there.
Well, he can be convinced.
I think that's probably a non-starter, especially, you know, we had a tragedy in this country just yesterday, right? Inmates took over a prison and murdered one of the guards. It was an AFSCME worker. The state has an obligation when you take people into custody and you are in control of their movements. The state has an obligation to, one, keep those inmates safe, but to also keep the workers who protect them or protect us from them. Safe as well. And so we know over time, and I can go back through history and have many, many times, we know that private prisons do not do as well.
This is not private.
Do not do as well in terms of those kinds of issues. And so the fight is always public versus private or lease versus sell. At this point, the governor has made it very, very clear that you got to buy it or it isn't going to open. He's all in favor of economic development and making certain that the community gets what they need, and they need jobs out there. I don't disagree with that.
If you can buy it cheap enough, fine. I don't care. But to me, that's a waste of state money.
So
they shouldn't be talking all this.
So, no, that's okay.
Sorry, I get real.
This is okay, Jim. Right. We're going to be jumping
across the table here pretty soon.
And people feel really, really passionate about this issue.
We all
believe that the community needs to have jobs. We get that. We know we need good paying jobs. But the number of prisoners that we have in Minnesota will not fill that prison. And so the only way to lease it and actually have state workers run it and do it is to have more people in than you are currently sending, which is a cost driver. In many instances, contracts with these private entities to run these prisons, they have a minimum number of people that have to be in the facility. And so it becomes very, very controversial and then becomes about liability. And frankly, we don't disagree that the area needs workers. We don't disagree that they need good-paying jobs. The question is that what the state needs?
Based on what you're saying, we don't have enough need then. I assume they were all going to be state, not employees, but inmates. But if it is, so I can learn.
Yeah.
Senator Hoffman?
More to be learned.
You know, it's interesting to hear this conversation that, you know, my in on this was Senator Dan Schoen actually is a law enforcement officer and went out there and the same conversation you and Bud are having, that he brought that up as well. And again, I thought there was a need as well, like Bud just said, and you're saying that, you know, that the population wouldn't fulfill that piece. So, you know, I'm glad people are taking a hard look at it. Yeah, jobs need to be developed out there. People need to be working again, and there's that piece of property that's sitting out there. There's got to be a way that we can utilize that to help create the incentive for doing that. And it was good to hear this conversation.
Senator Abler?
Oh, I thought we beat this topic to death.
Yeah. All right, that's fine, too.
I mean, say thank you.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. All right, very good.
Have a good night.
Don't go anywhere, folks. We're not done yet.
Fellow tomorrow at the Viking Cafe, that's what he's going to ask me about.
Absolutely. And that's what Dan was saying. He was there. He grew up in the area as a kid, and he was saying what
I thought you were done with this topic.
I know. Oh, sorry.
All right.